Hello, my name is Eric. This demonstration shows you how to enable security for attachments in Payables. To begin, we will log into the application as our IT security manager. As this user, we will select the navigator, and within the tools section, we'll select the security console. In the security console, we will select the administration task. Within the administration task, we will make sure that the general subtask is selected, where we can click the Manage Database Resources button. A database resource defines an instance of a data object, and a data object is a table, view, or flex field. Within the Manage Database Resources and Policies page, search for the display name equal to Application Attachment Category. The category appears in the search results with an object name of FND Document Categories. Further, the existing data security policies defined for the selected database resource appear in the Policies Details region. In the Search Results region for the selected database resource, select Edit from the Actions menu. Next, in the Condition tab of the Edit Data Security page, select Create from the Actions menu. Within the Create Database Resource Condition pop-up window that opens, we will name the condition and specify the attachment categories in scope for the data security policy. As mentioned previously, we will be creating a condition for a supplier portal user to view only external attachment categories. For example, the From Supplier category. Within this pop-up window, we'll enter the following details. As our name, we will enter AP External Document Categories. For our display name, we will enter the same, AP External Document Categories. For our description, we'll enter the following, AP Document Categories granted for external access. Within our condition type, we will select SQL predicate. Since we will be giving access to the From Supplier category, we will enter this within our SQL predicate. In this case, it will be category name in from supplier. If we were to be securing additional categories within this external document categories condition, we would provide all of those attachment category names within this SQL predicate. Once complete, we will go ahead and click Save. Once entered, navigate to the Policy tab of the Edit Data Security page. Here, we will select Create from the Actions menu. On the General Information tab of the Create Policy dialog box, we'll specify the name, start date, and module. By default, the module field is the module associated with the database resource for which you're creating the policy. In this case, that is application attachments. In this example, our name will be Grant on Application Attachments. Additionally, our start date will be the current system date. As mentioned, the module will remain the same as application attachments. Before clicking Save and Close, we'll navigate to the Role tab. Here, we will select the Add button. We will make sure that our application is selected as FSCM, and we will search for and select the role names to be assigned this new policy. As we'll be assigning this policy to a custom supplier portal role, we'll enter this custom role code into the role name field. In this case, our role code is for the supplier accounts receivable specialist custom job role. We will enter the role name as POS supplier accounts receivable specialist job custom. Here we can search, select our custom role, click apply, and OK. Next, on the rule tab of the Create Policy dialog box, we will select multiple values from the row set field, and we will search for the condition name that we previously created. In our scenario, the condition that we created was AP external document categories, which we can see is at the top of our list. We can select that record and click OK. Once selected, our description will automatically populate based on what we had entered previously. Lastly, before saving and closing, we will select the Action tab. On this Action tab of the Create Policy dialog box, we will move the actions from the Available Actions list to the Selected Actions list to specify the actions that are applicable to the data secured on the database resource, which will be granted to the roles that we selected. In this example, we're going to go ahead and grant all actions to this data security policy. Once complete, we're going to go ahead and click Save and Close. We'll receive a confirmation that this policy was saved successfully. Next, we will click Save on our Edit Data Security Policy page, and we will click Submit. This will update the database resource FND document categories. We can see we received a confirmation message that that database resource was updated successfully. And to finish, we will go ahead and click Done. We can now return home to continue on with step two. Next, we'll navigate to the Setup and Maintenance work area. Once here, we will select the taskbar and we will go to our Global Search task. Within the search bar, we will search for our Manage Attachment Entities Setup task. We can go ahead and select this task. Now, on our Manage Attachment Entities page, we'll need to search for and select each of the attachment entities that we're wishing to secure. Payables does have three separate attachment entities, and each one would need to have security enabled individually. However, in this case, we will go ahead and enter and search for the attachment entity AP Invoices All. Once entered, we can go ahead and click Search. We'll see that this entity is returned in our search results, and all attachment categories assigned to this entity can be seen here below. Within this search results section, we will go ahead and select this attachment entity and select the checkbox for Enable Security. If you do wish to enable security on additional entities at this point, you can go ahead and search for those within the entity name search bar. However, once complete, you can go ahead and click Save and Close. Once complete, this entity will now enforce any existing data security policy for roles, and your attachment security will now be in place.